Would you want a Manny Pacquiao fight? He may be looking for an opponent.
Most definitely. Why? You know? Why not?
How would you do again?
I'd do perfectly fine, man. I would definitely do way better than Algeria. You know what I'm saying? Manny Pacquiao is a good fighter, you know. He had over 50 fights. So his ring intelligence has grown throughout the years. He's not exactly the same fighter that he used to be, though he does have a lot of similar traits because, you know, we're creatures of habit, man. It'd be an exciting fight, and I believe it'd be one of the best opportunities for me to showcase my true abilities to the whole world.
If you land the right hand on him like Algeria, what happens?
It's over, baby. It'll be a flashback to that fourth rematch he had. You know what I'm saying? With Marquez. So at the end of the day, man, Pacquiao's a great opponent, man. He's a great champion. He's done many things throughout his whole career. But I do not believe that he's the best welterweight in the world.
How did you rate his performance against Chris Algieri?
Great, you know. He looked great, you know. He looked great for who he was in front of. Algieri wasn't ready for that kind of performance. Algieri, that was too big of a step up for him. You know, if you go from the chain of command, it should go Pavlovkov, Timothy Bradley, then Pacquiao. You know what I mean? So to go from Pavlovkov straight to Pacquiao, I believe was just too big of a jump.
What did you miss the most about being away from boxing? 8 months that your shoulder was giving you trouble. What did you miss the most about being
that third paycheck I would have got this year? You know what I'm saying?
How did you feel after the Julio Diaz fight? Like, how did you feel about your performance?
Oh, man, I felt great, man. I was so ready for that fight. We had a tremendous 10-week camp for that fight. My main focus for that fight was Mayweather, man. I kept him in my mind while I was on the treadmill to keep me motivated, you know. I'm really a young fighter who's just happy to be where he is in the stage of boxing, in the sport of boxing. And I'm just looking forward to evolving as a fighter, you know. I'm not afraid to lose. I'm not afraid to win some, lose some, and grow, man. Because when someone beats you or you get an upset, you get to look at yourself. You get to reflect, you know. And me and my team, we've been patting ourselves on the back for many years, man. And just like Floyd, who knows, man? I might be able to go a long time undefeated. I might not ever have to really reflect on the things that I'm doing wrong in the ring if another fighter can't capitalize on my mistakes. Everybody makes mistakes, but it's the other fighter's job to capitalize on them.
Do you think Floyd would realistically ever fight you?
I think so. If he really believes he's TBE.
But what do you think you have to get you to that position? What kind of fights do you need? If you could have any kind of 2015, assuming you get out of this fight on Saturday, you know, injury-free, what do you think you need to do to earn a fight like that?
Fight Marcos Maidana one time, do it right the first time, and then I believe the fans would be demanding the Floyd Mayweather fight before his contract is up with Showtime Network.
Do you think Maidana would fight? Because you guys were scheduled to fight once on HBO and he pulled out.
Yeah, but I don't know the full details, but I can tell you whatever he was offered then compared to what he'll be offered now will be substantially a different thing, especially come after my performance this Saturday night.